Everywhere you look these days, it seems like someone's trying to sell you something. On billboards, posters, stickers, elevators, gas pumps, airplanes, cups, napkins, coffee holders, wire hangers, even bathrooms. See, it used to be that when someone really wanted to sell you something, they could rely on the good old-fashioned 30-second TV spot.
He likes it! He likes it!
But thanks to the invention of this, and this...
Well, there's a revolution going on called Internet.
Fewer and fewer of us are actually sitting through these.
Anything is possible when your man smells like Old Spice and not a lady.
So how's a poor, struggling, multi-million-dollar corporation supposed to let you know they even exist?
Hey, welcome to Morning Joe, brewed by Starbucks.
Oh, we do have a special guest. Excuse me, I just have a sip here of my Starbucks.
Mm. There you go.
Welcome to the brave new world of brand integration. But you may know it by its old school name.
Converse All-Stars, vintage 2004.
Product placement.
You can use a Guinness.
Today, product placement is a multi-billion dollar industry that generates hard cash for movies, creates new identities for brands, but most importantly, delivers the holy grail of marketing, co-promotion. You see, co-promotion is what takes a regular movie and turns it into a blockbuster. Take Iron Man. That movie had more than 14 brand partners. Everything from a Whiplash Whopper to Iron Man Dr. Pepper cans to Tony Stark himself driving off in an Audi commercial. These types of partnerships deliver millions of dollars of free advertising for the movie, while also raising visibility for the companies themselves. But do all these co-promotions actually work? Do they have that much influence over the choices we make? Does Shrek make me want to take a Royal Caribbean cruise or Burger King make me want to go see Twilight? Is the only thing missing from my movie achieving Iron Man status a little co-promotion? Well, if that's true, then I can't wait to get some of that sweet Hollywood ad money. Last year, more than $412 billion was spent on marketing and advertising. And out of that $412 billion, just four companies controlled over 75% of it. If I'm going to make a blockbuster, it seems like these companies are a great place to start.